Montreal is in the throes of a violent biker war. The man behind the mayhem is Hell's Angel boss, Mom Boucher. Boucher is selling cocaine for the mafia on Montreal's streets. He wants to control distribution throughout the city. Yet one biker gang, the Rock Machine, fights to defend its territory. Dozens are already dead, but the war is about to intensify. 12:40 p.m., August 9, 1995. A residential street, just four blocks away from Mom Boucher's Hell's Angels headquarters. Kids are playing on the sidewalk. Hell's Angel Scott Steinert detonates a remotely controlled bomb. Steinert's target is a low-ranking biker, another victim in the tit-for-tat killing that is the hallmark of the biker war. But 11-year-old Daniel Desrochers is playing nearby. The explosion tears a Jeep apart and sends twisted metal across the street. Two small pieces pierce Daniel Desrochers' skull. He dies in hospital a few days later.
My team investigated this murder, and I can tell you today, the bomber saw the car, guy got in it, and he blew it up. He saw the kids playing on the other side of the street. He could have stopped. He could have said, well, I'll get him another day. And he didn't. And that's how cold-blooded that murder was.
Thousands of people follow Desrochers' funeral procession and march on City Hall.
The politicians got angry, and the citizens got angry. And that's when the government decided to pull out all the shots.
In response to the Desrochers murder, the Quebec government forms a Wolverine Squad, an elite anti-biker unit drawn from the Canadian Mounties, the Sûreté Provincial Police, and the Montreal Police. The Wolverines have one goal, to bust the bikers and bring Hell's Angel leader Mom Boucher to justice. The commander is André Bouchard.
The Wolverine Squad was created because the violence was getting out of hand, so they took the best of the best, and I'm very proud because they took me. I was proud of being chosen, but they also took a lot of my guys.
The Wolverines turn up the heat. They begin harassing Boucher's bikers in their own neighborhoods.
A lot of our investigation work is provocation. You knock on the neighbor's door. You knock on the business partner's door, and all of a sudden the phone starts to ring. Hey, did you get a visit from the... Yeah, who the hell's got that? And it starts. And they're so upset that they don't think that they're possibly being listened to. And they make mistakes.
As the Wolverines get to work, Boucher becomes increasingly paranoid. He fears informants and suspects bikers around him of treachery. In 1997, Boucher decrees that Hell's Angel prospects must prove their loyalty by an act of cynical brutality. The slaying of unarmed prison guards.
He has to his best recruits to kill two prison guards to make sure that there will be no way that those guys could one day make a deal with the police, because after killing a police officers or prison guards, then there was no way that the judicial system, the Justice Department, will agree to make those guys an informant.
Boucher believes the police will never make deals with cop killers. June 26, 1997. Prison officer and mother of two, Diane Levine, ends her shift at Montreal's Bordeaux prison. As Levine drives home, a powerful motorcycle pulls up alongside her minivan. Riding on the back seat is Hell's Angel prospect, Stéphane Godas-Gagné. Gagné fires one round into Levine's left arm and another into her chest. The second bullet pierces her spine. It's fatal. Less than 3 months later, Gagné is again involved in the shooting of prison bus driver Pierre Rondeau.
And when you start killing guards, you ought to send messages out. I kill them because I can kill them, and I can kill any one of you.
The police soon pick up Gagné. He succumbs to intense questioning and names Mom Boucher as the man who ordered the prison guard hits. Boucher's twisted test of loyalty hasn't worked. On December 18, 1997, the Wolverines pounce on their target. Police arrest Boucher on multiple homicide charges outside Montreal's Notre Dame Hospital, where the doctors are treating him for throat cancer. Unfortunately, the overworked federal Crown prosecutors are forced to go head-to-head with Boucher's highly paid legal team. The Crown's case is weak. Stéphane Gagné, the star prosecution witness, is a self-confessed murderer and career criminal. The jury is also perhaps nervous of Boucher's violent reputation. After the defense destroys Gagné's credibility, the jury finds Mom Boucher not guilty. For special prosecutor Randall Richmond, it's a bitter day.
The law enforcement community was very much aghast and disappointed.
Boucher celebrates his victory in a blaze of publicity. To some, he's become a folk rebel, thumbing his nose at the authorities.
He was on the shoulders of full-patched Hell's Angels as they left the courtroom.
The most feared man in the Montreal underworld is now free to go back to work. It seems nothing can stop him.
Maurice Boucher was public enemy number one, and his powers and influence were greater than they'd ever been before. He really thought that he could do anything he wanted. Call it megalomania if you want. Call it a psychopath. He really thought that he could intimidate the whole justice system and indeed the whole of civil society.
As a new century begins, cash from drug sales is now flowing into the coffers of the mafia and Hell's Angels in amounts that impress even the hardened cops who battle the bikers on a daily basis.
The account sheet shows $100 million for 11 months of operation.
Using seized documents, the Quebec Provincial Police, the Sûreté, estimate that Boucher's bikers make cocaine sales totaling $110 million during the year 2000 alone. Boucher has made it. He's top of the world. But the dream is about to turn sour.